Welcome to the EPG Parshala. I am Dr. Sriti Rai, Assistant Professor in the Department of Museology, University of Calcutta. In this course, Indian History and Culture, museology is one of the important contents that deals on museum. Today, I will orient you about the typology of museum, that is a part 2 in the module number 8. In earlier session, you have know and learned about the different types of museum in the module number 7, that was on typology of museum 1. In this session, you will know or understand about the diverse nature of Indian museum in terms of its nature, collection and function, and to focus the existence of various type of museum and its content. There are so many museum in India because India is the country with diverse natural and cultural heritage unique to the world. The rich socio-cultural heritage of India can be characterized under two categories. One is material and another is non-material, or you may say as tangible or intangible culture. In tangible heritage, we see old remnants, archaeological sites, art, crafts, manuscripts and many more. In case of tangible heritage, it includes tradition, music, dance, literature, folk, fables, rites, rituals, festivals, etc. So in such a way, our country is very diverse, and so museum play an important role in preserving and exhibiting their heritage for the knowledge of mankind. So no one type of category of museum is enough for portraying the heritage, and thus we have many categories of museum in India to preserve our heritage. If you go through the diversity of Indian museum, we can find several types of museum. One of them is National Museum of India. Government of India has established many museums as national museum under the direct control of the Ministry of Culture that represent the nation or national collection on the subject it is concerned. Like National Museum, it is in New Delhi. National Gallery of Modern Art, it is also in New Delhi. National Science Center in New Delhi. National Maritime Museum, this is in Mumbai under Indian Navy. National Telecom Museum, it is in Bhopal. National Library, it is in Kolkata. National Memorial, it is a cellular jail in Port Blair, Andaman Island. National Craft Museum, it is in New Delhi. And National Railway Museum. So these are the museum of national level. Museum of national importance are also there apart from the national museums. So other museums are, this kind of museums are very age old in nature. They have large collection, rare treasure and historical importance too. These museums are administered by the respective board of trustees and not directly under the control of Ministry of Culture. They are the Indian Museum Kolkata. This is the oldest museum in not only in India but in Asia. The Salarjung Museum Hyderabad, this is the largest one-man collection museum. And the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Vastu Sangrahalaya, it is in Mumbai. General or multipurpose museum is another kind of museum. In this kind of museum, it gather in the same place the collection of a diverse categories. Under history and art, specimen of arts, archaeology, numismatic, epigraphy, paintings, manuscript, arm and arbor, decorative arts, textile. These are exhibited, collected, exhibited and preserved. Under the science division, galleries are made on zoology, botany, anthropology, ethnology, etc. There are so many art museums like art galleries, portrait galleries, folk art museum, craft museum. All these museums are different in terms of its content. So there is a broad category under the art museum. So whenever we look into the art gallery, so this gallery, there are so many art galleries in India that exhibit the different art objects. There are few art galleries like Jaya Chamarajendra Art Gallery, it is in Mysore, Chitra Art Gallery in Thiruvananthapuram, Jahangir Art Gallery in Mumbai, National Gallery of Modern Art, this is shortly known as MoMA in New Delhi, and Bharat Bhavan, it is in Bhopal. So these art galleries generally portray the art exhibition, the art paintings, art objects. Other than art galleries, there are portrait gallery in different museums, or solely a portrait gallery also there in India. It collects and exhibits portraits of persons who had a distinct role in the history of country. Even many multipurpose or art museums have their separate gallery for the display of portraits. Like the Archaeological Museum and Portrait Gallery, Goa, has a gallery devoted to portraits on woods and canvas. So visitors can have a look into the different portraits, and they may know about their history, their lifestyle, and their contribution for India. Similarly, India have many folk art museums. The museum collection amply reflects the vigor and vitality of the rural life, along with a vivid picture of social tradition, religious belief, practices, motifs, and their aesthetic and cultural influence among the rural folk. Rural art comprises of art form made up of clay, wood, bamboo, leather, bark, bone, horns, etc. In India, Bharat Lok Kala Mandal, that is situated in Udaipur, Rajasthan, in this museum we can have a look of entire such kind of folk art objects. There are craft museum other than the folk art museum. India has good number of craft museum across the entire country. The National Craft Museum, New Delhi, contains a collection of traditional Indian crafts in textile, metal, wood and ceramic. There are some specialized craft museum too in India, like Kite Museum. This is in Ahmedabad, Utensil Museum and Textile Museum. These are in Ahmedabad city. These are all about the art museum and different categories of art objects, where you can see the crafts, folk arts and portraits and other picture galleries. Apart from this art museum, the other main category, other important category rather, the history museums. We can classify history museum again into the several subcategories, like archaeological museum, site museum, military or defense museum, transport museum, police museum, personalia museum, biographic museum, memorial museum, etc. So all this museum portray the history of a nation. In case of archaeology museum, the prehistoric or proto-historic phase of art and culture are exemplified by statuary art, pottery, tools, coins, minor objects and other treasure of the past, which seems to have witnessed evolutionary changes of our country and also landmark of aesthetic trends in context and cultural development. In India, number of archaeological museums are there. This is the maximum number of museums that India has. One of them is the State Archaeological Museum situated in Kolkata. And like that, there are so many archaeological museums across the country. Site museum, this is also a kind of archaeology or history museum, mainly run by the Archaeological Survey of India. The site museum are museum in situ. It means it houses loose dismantled antiquities, relics and other forms of collection found from the adjacent excavation or exploration site. These museums are established to preserve the small and movable antiquities recovered from the site and to retain them proper in their proper environment. Like Sarnath Museum, which is situated very adjacent to the Sarnath Monastery. This is a kind of site museum under the Archaeological Site Archaeological Survey of India. It exhibits the national emblem which was found in the Sarnath site. Again, there are so many defense museums. Defense bodies like Army, Navy, Air Force, they have their own history. So they establishing a museum, they exhibit, preserve their artifact, their achievements in for the common people. They exhibit the history of warriors, account of war, personnel and divisions and their various divisions, medals, peace accords, anti-conscription documents, used tank, aircrafts, weapons are all preserved and exhibited in such kind of museums. These are controlled under the control by the respective either Army or Navy or Air Force. Like one of the Army museum is in Kunnur, that is the Madras Regiment Museum. One National Maritime Museum, this is under Navy, situated in Mumbai. And one Air Force Museum is in Shillong, that is administered and controlled by the Air Force. Other than these museums, another variety is transport museum. India has long heritage of transport, so different kind of transport museums are also you can see in India. One of them is rail museum. The museum preserves the heritage of railway of a country. It exhibits vintage engines, historical records and documents, history of the development of railway, signaling system, etc. Three, four railway museums are in India. The National Railway Museum is in New Delhi, one railway museum is in Mysore and one is in Kolkata. Other than railway museum, there are maritime museum. Maritime transport is the age-old transport before the invention of any locomotives. So India has many heritage related to the maritime transport. The concept of the maritime museum has emerged with a view to safeguard the maritime heritage. This museum preserves and exhibits various types of safeguard seafaring boats and ships, objects from wreckage found at the bottom of the sea and or on the sandbank, semaphores, lighthouses, pictures, various equipments and accessories required for voyage, etc. It also highlights the modern activities and different issues. As I told, National Maritime Museum is one of its kinds located in Mumbai. This is under the Navy, Indian Navy. Police Museum is another important kind of history museum. The museum commemorates the history of origin, development and activities of police. In Kolkata, the Kolkata Police Museum revives the interface of the colonial police, that is during the British period, activities of police during British period, and Indian nationalism during the freedom movement of India. The National Police Museum, New Delhi, exhibit national and international significance related to police, crime and criminal activities. Personalia Museum is another kind of history museum. In memoriam of important personalities, Personalia Museum are founded with the aim of understanding his or her meaningful life that was contributed to the progress of his or her country or the world at large. These museums are generally established within the building where the great person had spent some of his life. Like Netaji Bhavan in Kolkata, the museum exhibits the this museum was a resident of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, and here people can view the documents, the photographs, the used furnitures of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Similarly, biography museums are also in India in large number. This museum are established on the collection of objects related to the great person in a new building, but mostly at the place where they were born or bred their last or work for some time. Such museum always depict the life, philosophy and activities of a great personalities. There is a chain of museum referred to the Gandhi Smarak Sangrahalaya, established throughout the country, dedicated to the memory of our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. So in this way, there are memorial museum, personalia museum and biographic museum related with a person that depict the history associated with a person, their contribution for the progress of the country and the knowledge and their achievements they have gathered, and this is for the common visitors. Other than these museums, these personalia and the memorial museums, there are so many other history museums, that is the period house museum. It displays the historical objects of certain time, fixed time. Period museums are established within the palace or forts or a resident of a significant or important personalities. Here you can see several kind of museum in palaces of India, like City Palace Museum, Cellular Jail Museum, all depicts the history of a period. Other than these history museums, there are so many archives and libraries that also preserve and store the history of a nation. In the government institution or individual preserve records for their future use, forming archives. National Archives in New Delhi, it also preserve the government, central government records, libraries. Apart from the archives, libraries are there that also preserve the documents and open to public use. Similarly, there are so many mass media museums. The mass media serve an essential purpose in making people concerned of policies and activities of the government and discussing them in the context of nation building affairs. A newspaper museum is in India, that is the Madhav Rao Sapre Smriti Samachar Patra Sangrahalaya and Research Institute, it is in Bhopal. It has collection of newspaper and periodicals since 1681, and some research paper are also in this museum for public interest. Regarding the mass media, one broadcast museum is in India that is known as a radio museum. It is established by the All India Radio at the Broadcasting House in New Delhi. He had recorded voice of national leaders and music of eminent singers along with the developmental history of All India Radio are preserved and exhibited. Telecom Museum is another important museum. It is in Bhopal. It's a unique and first of its kind in India that exhibit the evolution of the telephone. The museum is an excellent combination of obsolete and modern communication mechanism that have helped humanity to bring the world closer. In this variety, Postal Museum is another addition. India has few postal museums that exhibit the ancient tradition of runner system for delivering postal items, stamps, equipment, etc. It exhibits our heritage of sending messages through writing in postcard, inland letters and airmail. One of such museum is in Mysore. It is an excellent example of its kind. Other museums, among the other museum related to hobby, are quite interesting in India. There are philatelic museum. Philatelic museum preserve and exhibit stamps for the people of philanthropic interest. The National Philanthropic Museum, New Delhi, in Dak Bhavan, exhibits extensive stamp collection. The Postal Museum and Philatelic Library was established in Kolkata in 1979 as the premier in Postal Philatelic Museum in India. Museum of Hobby also includes Mountaineering Museum. Nowadays, mountaineering and trekking are considered as unique hobby. The Himalayan Mountaineering Institute has established a museum on Everest and mountaineering in Darjeeling, West Bengal. The museum exhibits colorful relic model of the Himalaya mountaineering dress and equipments, clubs all over the world, flags, pennants planted on the peak of Everest and Indian mountain peaks, etc. Numismatic Museum is another kind under this variety. A coin museum collects and exhibits coinage of a certain region or period. Many museums have numismatic galleries, but museums solely on numismatic are also in India. Among them, the Coin Museum in Nasik, Maharashtra, Currency Museum of the State Bank of India is located in Kolkata, are important. These are all about the history museum. So now look into the science section, the science, different categories of science museum. Under this variety, you can see natural history museum, eco museum, marine museum, zoological museum, botanical museum, forest museum, industrial and technological museum, science center, and anthropology museum. So, in Natural History Museum, the museum preserves and exhibits, they taxonomically they classify the botanical and zoological object. Here, specimens are exhibited depicting their natural habitat, forming a diorama through various using various fabricated objects. India has many Natural History Museums across the nation. One is in it was in New Delhi, that was National Natural History Museum, and unfortunately it was no more now. Regional Natural History Museum is in Bhubaneswar. Bengal Natural History Museum is in Darjeeling. Other than Natural History Museum, there are some eco museum in India. Eco museums are the best medium to explain and advocate sensitive conservational practices relating to environmental issue. They are established in an ecological setting like forest, national park, waterlands, tribal areas, etc. Like Rar Sanskriti Sangrahalaya in Midnapur, West Bengal, Kol Heritage Park, established by the Coal India Limited in Assam and Sanskriti Museum in New Delhi. Maritime Museum is another museum under the science category. India has many islands and a number of maritime museums are located in these areas. In Port Blair, there is Samudrika. This is under the Zoological Survey of India. It preserves the marine objects or specimens. The Marine Biology Museums of Central Center of Advanced Study in Marine Biology in Annamalai University is another museum of this kind. There are so many geological museums under the surveys or under the geological department of the respective colleges and universities. It also preserves the stuffed animal, taxidermy animal, and there are some museum example of this kind of museum is the Zoological Museum of University of Calcutta, Punjab University Museum, a Zoological Museum under the Zoological Survey of India, etc. Like Zoology Museum, there are so many botanical museums which are also run by the respective department of universities and also by the Botanical Survey of India. Like Museum of Botanical Survey of India in Botany Department of Punjab University and Birbal Sahani Institute, they have one museum on paleobotany. Other than the botany museum, the similar or near about this subject is the Forest Museum. The Forest Museum are established to give applied education on arboricultural on various field of forestry, forest biology, wildlife, timber and its uses, etc. The Forest Museum is situated in Port Blair, offers an insight into the forest activities through scale model and decorative piece made of locally available wood. So there are so many forest museum in India, like in Shivpuri, Madhya Pradesh, Guwahati, Assam, etc. Industrial and Technological Museum is another kind of under this variety. Under the direct influence of the Industrial Revolution in the 18th century, Industrial and Technological Museum were established throughout Europe. In India, it is flourished during 20th century, mostly under the National Council of Science Museum. The Birla Industrial and Technological Museum, Kolkata is one of its kind. The museum exhibit model on various branches of physical science, original instrument of scientific implements, models, multimedia presentation, all are available in this museum. There is another museum of this kind, that is the Visheshwariya Industrial and Technological Museum, is located in Bengaluru, is also preserved and the scientific technological heritage of India. Apart from the science museum, science and technological museums, National Council of Science Museum or NCSM runs various science centers like Science City Kolkata, National Science Center New Delhi, Nehru Science Center Mumbai. All these concerned centers communicate science through participatory exhibit, working models, time machine or visual aids, etc. in their respective centers. Anthropological Museum is another science museum. It collects material to present the story of the evolution of man, cultural and socio-economic changes, social behavior, livelihood, etc. Our anthropological museum are often called ethnology museum, where science of human race and their relation to one another pattern of the community are exhibited. Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Manav Sangrahalaya Bhopal has been conceptualized as an organic whole dedicated to unfold the story of human, highlighting human biological evolution in India. This is a open air museum. other than this science museum and the history museum, India has many specialized category of museum, like temple museum. India is full of temples and monasteries, and religion exerts tremendous influence on the Indian life and culture. Immensely precise ornaments, gems and other valuables are in the temple's possession. So many temples, they have constructed, they have established their museum separately, like the Venkateshwara temple at Tirupati. Other than the specialized museum, there's a kind of museum that is a peace museum. Man is generally peace loving. Peace museum include a range of different museums. It can be said that any museum which focuses on peace issues has the mission to serve as a museum of peace. An example of such museum is the Peace Museum, located at Mount Abu, Rajasthan. It is established by the Brahma Kumaris, the spiritual university and museum. It teaches people about the religion that led to God, and belief of each should reinforce the belief on own self. So through this session, hope you have understand the different subject area and their classification, and based on that, how the museum are categorized in India and their various role, their various objective, so that they can serve better for its audience or the visitors. In India, there is endless type of museum that are present and also coming day by day, looking at the expected people's demand. Going away from the mandate of museum as non-profit making permanent institution for the preservation of heritage, many of present day museums are developing, focusing on commercial interest with or without any real antique objects. India have many museums now. Every day people are establishing which have no real or antique objects. The new generation museum are drawing more attention of visitors, serving them as per their need. Indian diversities reflect vividly through the multiplicity of its museum in its every corner. So if you visit the museum, if you know more about the museum, you can better and you can fast grab the diversity of museum, how rich India is in terms of heritage. So in today's module, you can know about the different categories of museum as per which are classified based on the different subject areas, like the history museum, like the science museum, there's the specialized museum, peace museum, and the new trend of museum, those which are coming day by day. If you want to know more about this museum, you can go through the different books like Museum Basics, Museums of India, various directories which are available on museums, and you can go through the website of EPG Pathshala, where you can get the details or about this presentation and with examples and all description. Thank you.